So let's answer our SMT versus dual core quiz. We have a floating point intensive thread. It's going to use pretty much these two issue slots and very rarely use these. And then we have an integer only thread that only gets to use these two. So with a dual core processor, one of the cores really gets to be two issue plus maybe a little bit. Another one gets to be just two issue because it never sees floating point instructions that it needs to have more than two issue. In SMT, however, we would be able to do two instructions from this thread and two instructions from this thread per cycle. So we would be getting very similar performance. And as we have seen, then this is the more effective approach because the cost that we are getting here versus here is significantly lower. So we get similar performance for almost half the cost here. Now, what would happen, however, if we didn't have a floating point intensive thread and instead got two of these? In that case, the two core is slightly more cost effective because it gets the two issue performance in each core for twice the cost of one core, whereas this gets us the performance of a single core, because both of these are sharing the two issue slots, for a cost that is more than one core. So in that case, this would be the more cost-effective option. So as you can see, it's not that SMT always wins over multiple cores. It's that it depends on exactly what types of programs we have and exactly what's the distribution of issue slots among units and how different applications are using it. So the floating point intensive and integer only, and this type of a split between issue slots is an extreme example that makes the SMT look really good.